My day as an HR student starts by taking the train to the Leuven train station. Every Sunday evening and Monday morning, lots of students from all over the country arrive here to spend their week in the city, close to their university and college campuses. After arriving, I look for my bus at the bus stop adjacent to the train station. My campus is located just outside of town, so taking the bus is my best option if I don't want to be late for class.
I've safely arrived at the Gasthuisberg bus stop. We are now in front of the UZ Leuven, one of the most advanced hospitals in Belgium and in Europe as a whole. From here, it's only a little walk to campus. I better hurry up if I want to make it in time for class. I've made it in time for class. I've even got a few more minutes to enjoy the view from our campus over Leuven and its neighboring villages. The campus is located on a hill just outside of Leuven, so the town is very accessible for me and the other students. Our professor just wrapped up our class. I now make my way down the hill to take the bus back to town. Time for some leisure.
I'm back at the train station's bus stop again. From here, I'll make my way to the city center through the Bondgenotenlaan, a large avenue connecting the train station to the central square. This avenue is mainly famous for its many shopping possibilities. Along with the Diestse Straat, this is a street you need to visit if you need some brand new clothes. You will also find the city's movie theater here, the Kinepolis. As a student, you can watch movies a lot cheaper in Cinema Z though. It's not too far from here either.
At the end of the Bondgenotenlaan, in the middle of the Rector de Somme Square, you'll find Fonske, short for Fons Sapientia, which means Sword of Wisdom. The statue was gifted to the city to celebrate the 550th birthday of the Catholic University of Leuven and is basically a metaphor for the students of Leuven. It depicts a student who tries to pour wisdom into its head. The liquid he pours also signifies beer, as Leuven is very famous for its beer, with Stella Artois being known worldwide.
Adjacent to the Rector de Somme Square, you'll find the Grote Markt, which is a popular tourist attraction as it features the beautiful City Hall and the magnificent St. Peter's Church. The City Hall is probably the most famous building in the whole city, because of its 15th century late Gothic architecture. The many prestigious statues covering the building are testimony to Leuven's wealthy past and its glory days in the late Middle Ages. That's why it's one of the world's most famous city halls. On the other side of the square, you find the St. Peter's Church. This massive Gothic church was once planned to have the tallest towers in all of Europe, surpassing even the Notre Dame in Paris, but the swampy underground decided differently. But even without towers, the church is still a very impressive piece of Brabantian craftsmanship. On the Grote Markt, you'll find a few restaurants and bars, but these are mainly directed at tourists and older people and are rather expensive as well. Take a left at the end of the square and you'll find the famous Old Market Square, or Oude Markt, where you'll find a lot better bars who are cheaper as well. On the other side of the church, you'll find the Mochi. This frozen yogurt shop is very popular among students, ideal on a hot day.
Next, I arrive at the La Deuze Square, which can easily be recognized by the Beetle on a Needle, located in the middle of the square, a work from artist Jan Faber. On this square, you also find the University Library, one of the most famous libraries of Leuven. Many of us, including me, have spent hours here trying to get through our textbooks, but it's also a famous highlight for tourists from all around the world. Next to the La Deuze Square, you'll find the Herbert Hoover Square. Both squares are sort of connected and are used to organize the annual fair and Christmas market. Both events are very well known and extremely popular among students. I can highly recommend these events. When I've had a long day of studying at the library, I always enjoy a good meal at the Werf, also very popular among students. To stay in shape after all these good meals, I can enjoy some sports at Sportcox. That's our next stop. Let's go!
At Sportcox, universities provide lots of sport possibilities for students at a lower rate. Here, I come to enjoy some fitness, tennis, dance, running, volleyball, basketball, and so on. The possibilities really are endless. I really love the fact that you can switch between individual sports and group classes with a coach. Under normal circumstances, students can go and watch football matches in the Den Dreef Stadium, home to the Oud-Heverlee Leuven Football Club, located next to Sportcox. Another great location for sport enthusiasts.
It's been a very productive day so far. Let's enjoy some time relaxing in the park. Leuven has many beautiful places to enjoy nature or spend some time with friends. One of my favorites is the Kruidtuin, literally translated to botanical garden. It has a lot of flowers, small ponds, greenhouses, bees, chickens, ducks, butterflies and so much more. It truly is a magical place, and the best thing is it's only a 5-minute walk away from the city center.
Another park I really love to spend time with friends in is the Sluispark. It's a rather new park located in the Vaartkom neighborhood. The park is surrounded by lots of water from the Dela River and has large lawns where many students gather as soon as the weather turns all sunny and warm.
If I want to enjoy some running or a nice walk, I prefer what we call the Abdijvenpark, an abbey with multiple lakes, lots of nature and animals such as sheep, cows, ducks, swans and geese. It's located outside the Ring of Leuven, but not too far away by bike or even by foot.
I would also highly recommend the Groot Begijnhof, especially for those who are curious to see a well-preserved historical part of Leuven. The Begijnhof is about 3 hectares in size and has lots of small streets and apartments completely owned by the University of Leuven. To many foreign students, it provides a nice stay in Leuven during their study abroad.
After all of this relaxing and walking, I believe I deserve a little snack. Very famous amongst the students of Leuven is Tjalletje, a shop where they sell the best ice cream and other sweets. We have 2 of these shops, one located in a street next to the Oude Markt and one nearby the city park. On sunny days, you might want to keep in mind that you're not the only one who enjoys ice cream. Queues can be really long.
To end a long day, I'm going to the Old Market Square. This is one of the most lively squares in Leuven. It's a rectangular shaped square surrounded by 40 restaurants and cafes. You can come here for a simple snack, an extensive lunch, or a refreshing drink after a long day full of classes. The Old Market Square is also known as the largest bar in the world, thanks to its 40 plus cafes. Every student in Leuven has this is her favorite bar. So let's show you what our favorite places are to get a drink. To kick off, Nina's favorite place is a bar called Blokhut. It's a super fun place to go out, so definitely go check it out. Marta's favorite place to get a drink is Vesper. This is the most famous place for cocktails and shooters, so if you like that, make sure to pass by. Bram likes to go to Café Belgium. It's a typical old-style Belgian bar at daytime, but at night, the bar changes into a complete party zone with a DJ and a live band. It's the perfect place to get to know Belgium and the Belgians. The bar Sonia chose is Plaza. This is a typical sports bar, so if you're into football, you will definitely like Plaza. Just watching a football game with a special cocktail from the house or a beer. Last but not least is Sander's favorite café. The Bierkelder. This café's iconic feature is that the café is in a basement, but it is probably one of the coolest basements you have ever seen.
After a long night out, everyone gets a little hungry, so the best place to get a quick snack before you leave is at De Muur. Here you can get all kinds of snacks out of a wall, like chicken nuggets, spring rolls and a lot more. And if that's not to your liking, you can also pass by the McDonald's or Chick-A-Way. Everyone is familiar with these places, so no time to waste and go get your snack. much for joining us on our tour in Leuven, and we really hope to see you here soon. Bye!